Hello, how are you? Okay, so we're ready to start talking again. And we finished the cell chapter. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about a little bit about tissues. And I think I'm doing these out of order, but doesn't matter. We're gonna be talking a little bit about tissues. And then later in the same lecture, we're gonna talk about how genes are expressed. So when we start talking about tissues, I'm going to try and make it where you can see my board. We have four different kinds of tissues. And they are, what are tissues? They're cells that are closely associated with a similar structure and that perform a common function. So if we talk about cells that cover surfaces, your skin or inside of you, in covering surfaces inside of blood vessels, inside of your digestive tract, anything that is lining a surface is going to be an epithelial cell. Now, so when we, as we talk about various cells throughout the next, you know, the rest of this semester and next semester, we'll talk about a number of different kinds of cells. One of the more common ones we'll talk about is going to be a squamous epithelium or a stratified squamous epithelium, that's skin. And simple squamous epithelium, that would be what the inner lining of a capillary, what the smallest blood vessel type. We have those. Then we have various kinds that some of the ones that I was mentioning before about that had cilia, you know, we had talked about in your respiratory tract. We have something called a pseudostratified columnar epithelium. And that is the type of cell that is found on lining the surfaces of your respiratory tract in your trachea. And that's the ones that we had said had the cilia that sweep the material out. Okay, so lining surfaces are epithelial cells. The next group are connective tissue. Now, when you say connective tissue, I mean, I'm sure everybody would say, oh, tendons, that makes sense. You know, it's connecting stuff together. Tendons, ligaments, cartilage, all of those are cells, connective tissue. But the definition is kind of weird. It's the cells that are in a matrix. And so when we talk about cartilage, you have little cells living in openings in that stuff, you know, in that cartilage. Like if you eat a piece of chicken and you get that chewy, rubbery kind of stuff, that's cartilage. Blood is cells in a liquid matrix. Bone is cells in a bony matrix. These are all examples of connective tissue. Now, the other two examples of connective tissue are kind of obvious. Muscle tissue, so we have three different kinds of muscle tissues: skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle, the muscle that moves stuff through your hollow organs, through digestive tract. And nervous tissue. Nerves, pretty straightforward. So that's slide one. I'm going to talk about slide two also in this first video. And I'm scooting my studio over. It's a little stand that holds my phone. I'm scooting my studio over so that we can see a couple of definitions. So it ends up, tissues can change type. We were just talking about the four types, the four categories, and in each of those categories, there's different types of cells, different types of tissues. But it ends up that they can change type. And generally, that's is not a good thing. It's usually in response to something like a carcinogen, you know, this changing. And so we have a couple of examples. We have one, it's called a metaplasia. So I had mentioned that pseudostratified squamous epithelium, and I'd said that it ends up, and we'd said, what is the function of it? We'd said, oh, it has the cilia, it helps clear the dust and material that you breathe in. Well, smokers, they're exposing this epithelial tissue layer to carcinogens and mutagens and other toxins. Well, it ends up these have an effect on that pseudostratified squamous epithelium, and they cause it to change. And so anytime you have a tissue type that changes type, we're going to call this a metaplasia. Now, what about that smoker who's smoking away? And oftentimes you can tell a smoker. You just walk into the room and you hear that person over there coughing. Why are they always coughing? Yeah, they're breathing smoke. But what happens is they change that tissue that I was mentioning earlier, that pseudostratified squamous epithelium that has the cilia, they change it to stratified squamous epithelium. Doesn't have cilia, so they have a harder time getting that stuff out of their lungs. And that's why people have a smoker's cough. Now we have another bad change. It's a neoplasia. And in a neoplasia, neo means new and plasia means growth. In the case of a neoplasia, this is sort of a precancerous condition. It's a new, uncontrolled growth of cells. So we don't want either of those. All right. We will talk about tissue repair on the next video, and then we're going to shoot right on into our discussion of gene expression.